O is for Oconee Bells. Oconee Bells is found in a very narrow elevation range between 900 and 1400 feet elevation in the escarpment region of the southern Blue Ridge, that area where Piedmont transitions to mountains. And most of this plant is confined to South Carolina. It's found right around Lake Jocassee and Lake Kiwi, and also here at the South Carolina Botanical Garden. And really, other than a tiny little area up in McDowell County, North Carolina, nowhere else on Earth. This plant was discovered by a very famous French botanist by the name of André Michaux. And he came to this area in June of 1787. And when he found this plant, it wasn't in flower. He collected it, he dried it, and he took it back to Paris and deposited it in the museum there. Well, this guy actually had the audacity to die before he gave his new plant a name. So this plant went without a name until 1830. In 1830, another famous botanist, Asa Gray, the father of American botany from Harvard University, visited the Paris Museum, found this plant in the collection, and realized this is an entirely new genus and species of plant, a type that hadn't been found before. So he wanted to name it. Well, he named it Shortia gallicifolia. That's the scientific name of Oconee Bells. But the important part here is that Gray named this plant without really knowing where it grew in the wild. 90 years after it was discovered, it was finally rediscovered. It was finally found. But the amazing part is, this plant was rediscovered by a 17-year-old boy, George Hyams, in 1877. Isn't that amazing? All these great botanists scooped by a 17-year-old boy. So the saying goes with Oconee Bells, it was found by a man who didn't name it. It was named for a man who never saw it, by a man who couldn't find it. An amazing plant and an emblem of South Carolina.